I can't get to the other side of the shack, but it's like a 20-foot wall up higher as it comes over the top of the Mead Falls. That's insane. The amount of water that's moving through here. It's one continuous line over the top of that falls. It's normally like four or five different little rocky areas where there's independent waterfalls. That's insane. Never seen that much water coming over to the Mead Falls before. Of course, that damn tree's blocking half the view. Here I am on 4th Street, right here by the little bridge. Can't remember what that river's called. Tuttle River, whatever it is. Look at the water bubbles purging up through the dirt underneath. That's how roads give out. Side of road over there, which was a normal dirt pullover, that's washed out, man. Look at it, it's under 2 feet of water over there. Whole field, all the debris is floating in. Otter Creek is only about maybe a couple hundred yards that way. And I'm only maybe where I live, 10 feet higher, 12 feet higher in elevation than this, so hope it doesn't get too damn worse. Yesterday it was parked right up there by that telephone pole. Today the water's receding, thank God. The rain stopped for the last few hours. It's gone down, must have been about a foot, but not too much. So anyways, a foot is better than nothing. Look that way behind me, it's still flooded over the bridge. That little river creek that goes there. I'm not gonna drive over that bridge. That thing caves in something, I'd be dead. Anyways, it's dropping, thankfully. There's Metal Street Park, the tennis courts, the playground, everything's underwater. I don't know why they got the fire truck down there. I don't know what they're gonna do. I don't know if they're trying to pump it out, what they're trying to do to it, but these people's houses are probably, their basements are all flooded. It's water in their yards. I don't know if you can zoom in and see that water lying in the yard, but yep. Get a photo of this and then we'll get it over to Mead Falls. Here's the center Rutland Bridge. See the pipes? Electricity, water, whatever else goes through up there. River's right below there. That's insane. Yesterday it was down considerably, a lot more. That's insane, man. It's risen that much. Look how fast that water's moving. Okay, it's dying down, coming over the falls. Instead of one big wave, it's a couple. You can see the rock formation out there. That's insane, man. Look how fast that's moving. Gotta be 50 miles an hour, 45, I don't know. It's quick. Still about halfway up to the trestle. Somebody told me this morning it was hitting the trestle. I don't know about that. But you can see where all this road and all this was all wet. This was all underwater this morning. Look at the water's even flooded back over there. I didn't realize the woods went that far back. I think it washed it all out, tell you the truth. Look at that, because that was all filled in bank back there. That means this bridge might be getting undermined. Son of a gun. Look at that, that's about as close as I want to get. There's a trail that goes out here. This has all been backfilled with rock and gravel, but what happens is rock and gravel stuff gives away while I'm out there. I go down the river never to be seen again. Can you hear the sound of that? It's like thunder. I can feel the ground vibrate where I'm at. That's insane. Okay, came down the trail another 25 feet. That's as close as I'm getting, about 25 feet from that river. Look at that, the water's almost up to that trestle. The water's never that high, never that close. Oops. The sound, the vibration, the mist, that's insane. There's usually a bank 20 feet down, 25 feet down to the river right here. It's full. This was all under floodwater earlier this morning. That's what makes me leery to get too close. The bank slides in, something like that. Okay, right there is College of St. Joseph. Right over here is a little pond. Little pond and all the yard is no longer a pond. It's a big swamp hole, and the water's coming right across the road. There's a fire truck in front of me. I don't know where he turned or where he went. Hopefully he didn't go through there, because I'm not going through there. Look how muddy that is. That means debris and silt and everything else is in there. Way over there in the grassy area of the College of St. Joseph. To get it to focus. The geese are enjoying the wet grass in the yard, but anyways, I'm going to backtrack out of here. This is all muddy, all flooded. We're on Route 3 to East Proctor Road, said road closed. I'm not going any further, but you can see the culvert over there that's normally dry. It's full of friggin' water. Look at this. This is insane. Right down the edge of the bank. It's got to be at least 2-3 feet deep. It looks like I'm up on Lake Champlain, an island pond. Somewhere out there, by that tree line, out back, the further one back, it's where Otter Creek actually goes through. See a farmer's cornfield over there. It's all underwater. Corn will probably grow like crazy after all this silt and dirty water subsides, but it'd be so muddy. Don't know if the farmer will be able to come out here and harvest the corn later in this evening, so. Look at that. That's insane. United States Geological Survey crew is up on the bridge by Mead Falls up this way about a half mile. They got a little device hanging in the water trying to read the volume of water that's going past the bridge. I don't know how the hell they're going to figure that, because if you think about it, the river's normally 60, 70 feet wide by 5, 6, 10 feet deep, depends on the season, and it's right up to the bottom of the bridge. At 25, 30 feet and 100 feet wide, so I don't know how they're gonna figure that math, but it's a lot of water, more water than I've ever seen. This is all farmland right here. Otter Creek is out there. Can you see the waves? See how fast it's moving out there? Look at the white caps. It's insane. I thought water's moving 40, 50, 60 miles an hour, but it is moving. Somebody's gonna come drive across the bridge. You're coming down Door Drive. It's all closed. I don't trust these bridges, man. When I was a kid, I seen the bridge washed away in East Wallingford with water just like this. Just took the bridge, undermined it, and took it down the river. Here comes somebody over the bridge. Are you brave enough to come over the bridge? Your movement vibration could wash it away. Anyways. This rock face right here. It's usually Oh, no, no, it's a long ways down to the bottom of the river right there. 25, 30 feet? Yep. It's over there in those people's yard, their house. Little house right over there. It's insane. Look at this. Amazing amount of water. Came out a little bit further to show you the rapids. Surprised that nobody's whitewater rafting down this thing. High high is a ham radio operator's way to say laugh out loud. More cars are going over to the bridge. Look at that water. It's insane. Literally, you could sit there on that edge, or stand by the edge and drop a line down to the water. 25, 30 feet. Here comes a piece of debris floating down the water. What the hell is it? It's white, it's square looking. Looks like some kind of a oil bottle. Huh. The fish are probably way downstream. There's no way a fish could hide behind a rock. Oh, here comes some more debris. Probably logs, rocks rolling down that river under that water. Insane. What worries me, that dam gives out, there's a big massive tidal wave and I'm tucking out and I'm never found.